Hello viewers, today for the initial checking out of, we have this telephone. This is a RadioShack, a telephone made in Korea. The model number is 43-326D or 0. I guess it's D. And it does comply with part 68 of the FCC rules. So, I don't know how old this is, but I think this is probably maybe 80s at oldest, because it has like some cheap features to it, like the non-detachable cord. I would say this is an 80s or a 90s replica telephone. This definitely is not original to the time period in which these were made. There is something sticky all over the handset. I believe that's where the price tag was. But these have a really good design, because the way the microphone comes out in front, you can really get close to it. And so you get a good pickup. The Rotary has that head in there. And you know, some of the brass is starting to get tarnished. Not surprising around here, because you know, when you're using it, you're going to be touching it, and so it's going to tarnish. Same thing with the rotary dial, so we'll have to polish it up again. But the plastic is in pretty good condition. It doesn't appear to be yellowed much at all. And one of the nuisances with these permanently attached cords is that you can't easily connect it to the testing line. I think I can use this to make a junction here. Let's see. Oh, and the cord is the broken. Well, the tab is the broken, which is one of the annoying things about these attached cords, because now I can't just replace the cord. I have to crimp on a new plug, and it's not staying in place. So you may have an issue getting through this video. Let's see. Maybe I can use this to clip it shut. I could. Okay, great. So, now there's an unsightly clip in the video, but whatever, that's what it gets for having a stupid design. Okay, so let's go ahead and call this telephone. I don't believe it has any ringer settings, so the ringer should be on, as it should be. And there's the ringer. It is operating in person. It does sound a bit muffled, so I'll put it on a block of wood and see if that makes it any louder. Didn't make a big difference. It sounds like one of those cheaper single gong ringer is. If it was a dual gong ringer as found in a 2500 set, it would have sounded a fair bit nicer. Now let's go over to the mains and see if the audio is good. Does seem like it. It's dialing. Well, it doesn't seem like it dialed correctly. Let's try it again. Well, the tone sounded correct to me. Maybe I just took too long.
Good evening. know-how handles big dreams for...
There it goes.
What know-how can do. Member FDIC and Equal Opportunity Lender. Today is Wednesday, February 16th.
Sounds clear to me.
Temperature 40 degrees. A sunny morning, partly sunny afternoon, high today 45, mostly cloudy tonight, lows around 40. Thursday.
Okay. Let's see. I believe it has one of the older earpieces in there. Yeah, kind of old. It doesn't look too old, actually. It's kind of a newer. It's the older style where it's the heavy metal thing that comes out, but this piece doesn't look like it's all that old. I don't know if this comes apart at all. Doesn't seem like it. No, I guess it does. This is the old carbon microphone. Looks like it's in good conditions. Everything is pretty clean in there. There's the contacts. That should sound fine. It's in good shape. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and call the testing phone line and record a message. We had a little freak show with the messages because it kept filling up, but they did eventually all get recorded.
Three old messages. Message one.
Well, I can certainly see a problem with this telephone, and that is the fact that the wind from one's nose seems to pass right in front of the microphone.
Okay, so I think the pickup was really good. It was very loud and very constant. It didn't have a lot of high frequency sensitivity, but that's just typically how these carbon microphones are. They don't pick up a whole lot of detail, and that's why we have generally switched over to the use of condenser microphones. But these certainly have their benefits as well. You can have a lot of background noise with one of these telephones and it won't get picked up, so you can be heard clearly and you won't hear a lot of background noise. Whereas if you're talking on a telephone with a condenser microphone and you have background noise where you are, the party that you're calling is going to hear all that noise. So anyways, that's going to be it for this telephone, this RadioShack telephone. We'll get this cleaned up, and this is definitely a telephone I'm going to put into service somewhere.